Let's talk about Z drive rods. This is a 1mm pitch drive rod. Usually you use a T8 with this type, but this is 1mm pitch. This is actually for a 2mm one. This is a M8 rod. It uses a 1.25 pitch. And then you have a M5 rod that has a pitch of 0.8. This is what it actually would drive for the M8. You have two M8 nuts that you put in it, one on either side, and it'll allow it to drive it up and down on the actual axis, and your x-axis will be on that as well. For one of the ways that you would actually drive it, you use a stepper motor. This is a NEMA 17 stepper motor. It uses a coupler. In this case, the coupler has a M5 hole in the center. And then on the other side, you have a M8. So you'd use it for either one of these rods. And it would be secured on your NEMA 17 right here. You also have a X and Y axis. That's usually driven by a GT2 pulley with a GT2 belt. This is a 2mm pitch. And then you have a GT2 pulley. In the next part of the video, I'll show you how to actually figure out what your steps are for your stepper motors. So we're on the Prusa printer calculator. We're going to figure out what to do with our particular stepper. As we can see, there is several other subjects covered in here, but we're going to start with this one. It's the belt-driven system. This is usually used for X, Y. It can be used for Z. Normally, most people use a 1.8 degree step, which gives you 200 revolutions in a full circle. There are other options. There's a 0.9. And that will give you 400 steps per revolution, but for this case, we're just going to use the 1.8. Now, if you look over at the driver microstepping, it says there's a 1/16th step, which I showed in a previous video, how to set up on the RAMPS board. There are other choices that you can use. There's a 1/32nd step, but for now, we're going to stick to the 1/16th. Now, our belt pitch is a GT2. Which means that it's a pitch of 2. So we're good for that for the moment. This is where it's specified. Now the pulley for the GT2 is actually 16 steps in our case. So that's the number of teeth on the pulley, and that'll give us 100 steps per revolution. So that's where we are for that particular setting. So the switch you want to copy down is 100 for your Marlin configuration. I'll show you in just a moment. Now we have the lead screw. This would be usually the Z axis. It uses the same type of motor for this case, which is a 1.8 degree step. And the driver for the RAMPS board is 1/16th. The Pulu driver. And then we have a pitch of 1.25, which is M8. And then we have our M8 specified over here, but we can choose other things like the M5 that I spoke about earlier or something else. And it says for the default on this that it's going to be 2560 steps. So we're going to take those two values, we're going to put them into the Adreno, but in order to do that, we have to do it through the Marlin firmware. So in Marlin, we're going to do a search, and we're going to look for default axis steps per unit. That comes right up. Right now it has a default setting of 80, 80, 4000. In 500, and that stands for X, Y, Z, and the first stepper for the filament or the extruder. So we're going to change this value to 100, this value to 100, and this one to 2560. Now these values will change when you proceed to configure your printer for the correct number of steps, because there could be other factors that cause it to be slightly off. But those are another video in itself. It's for calibration. So what we're going to do is we're going to save and upload this. In order to do that, we have to connect to our RAMPS Adreno configuration for the 2560. So I'm going to plug in the USB. And we're going to see if we have the port selected, which we do. We're then going to compile and upload. And if you like my video, please press the like button. I'll try and do a video every week, and subscribe if you'd like. Thank you very much for your time.